It's interesting, Jake, that it follows what is considered to be a fairly significant change on the part of the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell from his proposed rules resolution that was released last night as to what actually was released during the course of this trial.
It's surprising given how strongly Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell rules the Senate. I mean, one would think that he wouldn't have introduced the rules package he did if he didn't know for a fact there were 51 votes. And so I wonder if he was in danger of losing the vote if he did not change the package. What the bill does now is the two big sticking points for some Republicans and for every Democrat was that each side, the House managers and the Trump side, were going to be given 24 hours to make their case, but they had to do that over 2 days. That meant 12-hour days starting at earliest with no breaks, 1 p.m., meaning that it would not end until at the very earliest, 1 a.m. That's one issue. And then the other issue, of course, was whether or not the evidence compiled by the House would be automatically included or would it have to be up for a vote to the point that maybe this evidence wouldn't even been included. Let's bring back Dan Abash to tell us what Mitch McConnell has done to change these issues that Republican senators and every Democratic senator were having with these rules. Dana?
It is a very remarkable situation, as you were both discussing, given how every single move that the majority leader makes has been, and he knows would be, scrutinized by all parties, especially his fellow Republicans, who he has been so clearly, understandably, trying to protect, because a lot of these Republicans, including Susan Collins of Maine, if they don't win re-election, and if you know, four of them don't win re-election, he will not be the majority leader anymore. That is first and foremost in his mind. He talks about the institution of the Senate, but that is the reality. So our Phil Mattingly has been doing some excellent reporting on this, and I'll let you give some of the details, but broadly, our understanding, and my understanding in talking to a source familiar with the discussions, is that while the public discussion has been about whether or not these key Republicans will allow witnesses, privately, the discussion had been about other issues, like in making the House Democrats' whole information, their whole case, admissible and on the front end, and even broader things, like you were saying, like how long each day will go, but more importantly, admitting the evidence on the front end. That was something that some of these key Republicans went to Mitch McConnell on and said, whoa, what you're doing, you're taking it too far, you should change this. And so he agreed to do it. And it happened so quickly that I believe we have a photo of it. There's handwritten changes. It didn't even have time to go back to the clerk for a formal change. It was done by hand before being formally introduced just a short while ago. That just shows you how quickly the changes were and how, you know, even Mitch McConnell, who says he, you know, who understands his caucus, has to kind of try to bend to their will while he's obviously trying to bend to the will of the White House, which wants this done quickly. And there's also a school of thought that giving people like Susan Collins a win early on in this, a political win, isn't such a bad thing for Susan Collins and other Republicans.
All right, Dan Abash, thanks. So, Wolf, just to be clear, this is now changed from instead of the 24 hours over 2 days, it's going to be 24 hours over 3 days.
For each side.
For each side, which means 8-hour days, theoretically, which is much more manageable and also will not run into the early hours of the morning. And then in addition, it will be automatically, the evidence automatically will be included in the record in the Senate, although members could vote later to take stuff out if they want to strike it from the record. But it would have to be, so it's an opt-in situation. Mm-hmm. So those are two very significant changes.
You know, I want to bring in Caitlin Collins and Phil Mattingly. Caitlin, first over to you. You're over at the White House. Give us a sense of what led to this fairly dramatic change.
So we're actually learning something interesting about the White House's role in all of this. We are being told that the White House had an initial role in that first language that Phil and them had been talking about of this resolution, where it wanted those 2 days for those arguments, that 24 hours to argue over a time period of 2 days. And we're told the reason the White House wanted that is because the defense here, the House managers get to go first and make their case. And the White House was worried that they would get pushed, given all the motions that you're likely to see today, that they could get pushed and their argument would be broken up over the weekend. So theoretically, if the House does start making its argument tomorrow, they could have Wednesday and Thursday. And then the White House was worried that if there were a lot of motions, they would be pushed and potentially Saturday and onto Monday, and their argument would therefore be broken up. They think they don't like that because, of course, it could potentially affect their coverage. They may not get as good of coverage if they have their argument broken up after the House is gone in a consecutive manner of days. So they played a role in pushing for that language and that initial resolution, wanting that 2-day time period over the 3-day time period. We are told that a lot of that had to do with the White House. And of course, it makes sense because if the White House does use all of their time now with this 3-day change that we just saw McConnell make, they would be presenting their arguments if they go after the White House, after the House, on Saturday, Monday, and Tuesday. That would break them up on Sunday with that day that they will not be in session for this impeachment trial. So that actually had a lot to do with that. It's a good question of what their response is going to be, what the president's response is going to be, because he just got back to his hotel in Switzerland as his attorneys were on the floor making their opening arguments there, as you saw them going after Adam Schiff had been speaking. So the question is, what is his response going to be? We should note that he has plenty of time to watch this. It's about 9 o'clock in Davos, and the president does not have anything else on his schedule for right now for the rest of the day.
Yeah, I suspect he is watching, and I suspect he's not going to be very happy that it's going to be spread out over 3 days as opposed to 2 days. But Phil, you're getting some information on why the Senate Majority Leader had no choice but to make this concession.
Yeah, Wolf, let me walk you through some of the behind the scenes. According to several people who were involved in the events that transpired a couple hours before the trial actually began, when these changes were actually made. Something to keep in mind here, and I think there's a theory of the case that the Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has had throughout the last couple of weeks preparing his members for this trial, and that is unity is extremely important for the entirety of the conference. All 53 Republicans, keeping them together for as long as possible will only pay dividends the longer the trial goes. That's been what McConnell has preached to his members. It's been what he's kept in mind as he's negotiated behind the scenes on the actual details of this resolution. Now, what I am told is he was not in danger of losing the vote on this resolution, but he was in danger of losing some Republicans. Several Republicans made clear earlier this morning that they had issues with those two specific changes that ended up being made. They had issues with compressing the trial into 2 days. They had issues with the fact that they were going to have to vote to admit the House evidence later on in the trial. They felt like those were things that didn't need to be a part of this and things that should have been addressed up front. Susan Collins said, for one, that she wanted the changes made, her spokeswoman saying her position has been that the trial should follow the Clinton model as much as possible. She thinks these changes are a significant improvement. Ohio Senator Rob Portman was also involved in this process. The reality is McConnell read his conference. His conference was making clear that to stick together, they needed changes. The changes were made, guys.
All right, Phil Mattingly and Caitlin Collins, thanks so much.